can't be everything to everyone, or can we? The station that leaves no listener behind, AM 1050 KCAA.
Ladies and gentlemen, he's a child of God. A husband, NRA conservative, radical right-wing supervillain, and Twitter rock star. American by birth, Texan by choice, and a badass by nature. He's the owner of TomOHalloran.com, OHalloranMedia.com, and PatriotRadio.net. Please welcome Tom O'Halloran.
This hour's over, the terrorists may have already won. If you'd like to join the conversation tonight, please call in at 888-909-1050. If you'd like to listen on the phone, the number is 832-999-1050. You can also join the live stream video at patriotradioshow.com. You can log into the chat room as well. Again, my name is Tom O'Halloran. On Twitter, I am TPO underscore himself. My primary blog is TomOHalloran.com. When you get there, please be sure to follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Spreaker, any other social media that suits your fancy. Also, while there, please follow my editor, Veronica Coffin. Veronica does most of the heavy lifting on my websites these days, and without her doing that, I wouldn't be able to do this. We've also launched our Facebook page, so please find Facebook.com/Patriot Radio Show. I'm on air three nights a week, so please be sure to catch my Wednesday night edition, same time tomorrow night. And on Fridays, I do Jihad on America. Friday nights, same time, 7 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Jihad on America, where I cover the Islamists in America, who they are, what they want, and why you should be afraid. Each week, we continue pulling back the mask of Islam, looking at what's being done in the name of Allah, both here and abroad. And I do the abroad part because it's a look into the future of America if we allow this cancer of Islam to spread here in the homeland. If you did not catch my show on the Muslim Brotherhood or my show, Islam is Not a Religion, please do yourself a favor. Do me a favor and do America a favor. Find your way to PatriotRadioShow.com and listen to these two shows. They will open your eyes, and you'll never hear the word Muslim or Islam again and feel the same way about it. Keep abreast of my shows. Listen to the live stream as well as archives of shows that you may have missed, all at PatriotRadioShow.com. I'd like to thank tonight's sponsor, Amelia Hamilton. She's the author of 10 Steps to Freedom and One Nation Under God. These are the first two books in the Growing Patriot series. If you know someone that's raising little kids and you want to get them off on the right start, teach them about our heritage, about the America that was once great, please find your way to growingpatriots.com and check out these fabulous books. I'm going to start off tonight the way we start off every show. We're doing a countdown through the 107 counts of impeachment, 107 reasons why Obama could and should be impeached. We do this each week to remind us, because a lot of these crimes have passed months and even years ago, and I don't want you to forget what this guy has been up to. So each week we go through a half a dozen of them. Obama's been using the executive decree to allow 80,000 Muslims to enter America, and next year, 100,000. And 100,000 again each of the next 5 years. The Obama administration has failed to enforce century-old law meant to prevent illegal immigrants from taking root in the government, in the U.S., only to get on the government dole. The Obama administration's release of thousands of illegal aliens that are criminals, violent criminals, and that they've been in detention centers and prisons around the country, he's released over 16,000 of them, including murderers and rapists, and they now walk amongst us, among us. The Obama administration was revealing political opponents' private tax information to the media. Absolutely criminal, absolutely deserving of impeachment. Obama administration has been allowing the Saudi bomber to be deported, the third Saudi bomber to be deported to Saudi Arabia, one of Obama's sons. Also, he will not charge the Boston bombers as enemy combatants. He wants to charge them as criminals. Of course he does. He wants them to have all the rights that he can heap upon them. Next up, before we get to the news, oh, exciting news. If you were in here last week, we had a great show. My friend, my brother, fellow patriot, Bill Perryman was on. We had a great, great show, one of the best, and he's going to be joining us again right after the first break, so please stick around. Up next, Obama's been pitching the illegal aliens as nice neighbors that just want to come up and provide for their family. They're just nice people. You'd want them as your neighbors. Well, let me remind you of the people that are actually coming up here. It's not his fictitious dream of what they would be like. Luis Garcia, illegal alien, was convicted of possession with intent to distribute cocaine and marijuana in Brownsville, was sentenced to more than 11 years in prison. Samuel Nevarez, a Mexican illegal alien, convicted in Idaho, conspiracy with intent to distribute methamphetamine, convicted, sentenced to more than 24 years in prison. Herman Sapone, Guatemalan illegal, was sentenced in Tennessee to more than 15 years in federal prison for sexually abusing a Guatemalan girl that he illegally brought across the border. Benito Ozuna, a Mexican illegal, was sentenced to nearly 20 years in prison for cocaine trafficking. These are not nice people. Don't buy the Kool-Aid that Barack Hussein Obama is selling. He's bringing across some kids, massive amounts of illegals, jihadis. We're finding prayer mats on the border. We're finding dead little bodies washing up on the shore because people from Central America are sending their babies up so that they can get in. These children are being raped, they're being abused, they're being killed, and their little bodies are washing up on the shore of the Rio Grande. Every injured body, every injured child is blood on Obama's hands, every one of them. Mexican illegal was busted in San Diego, just outside of San Diego. Pulled up at the border. The girl was acting a little hinky. The passenger wouldn't roll her window down, so they directed her into secondary inspection. She had 38 pounds of drugs in her car, over $500,000 worth of drugs. These are not nice people. She wasn't coming up to pick strawberries, people. Don't buy the liberal spin. They're coming up to drug your kids, to kidnap your kids, probably to sell your kids into slavery. Burger King's looking at moving to Canada. They're going to buy a restaurant chain up there and become the third largest restaurant chain, fast food chain in America with about 18,000 stores. Buying them would let them move their headquarters to Canada, and they would save boatloads of tax money, from money that's made outside the country, because now they're not bringing it back into this country where it would be double taxed. They can keep it up in Canada. Use American money to grow American stores. Folks, we got a whole lot more coming up in the next 45 minutes. Bill Perryman will be in as soon as we get back from this break. Please stick around. It's going to be a great show. I promise you.
KC. A.
Tom O'Halloran.
We'll put a boot in your ass. It's the American way. All brought to you courtesy of the red, white, and blue.
Welcome back. If you're just joining us, this is Patriot Radio, and I'm your host, Tom O'Halloran. Joining me now is my good friend, my brother, fellow patriot, Bill Perryman. Billy, you on the line, brother?
Yes, I am. How are you doing tonight, Tom?
Hey, doing real well. So glad you're able to come back. Had a great time last week.
I appreciate that. Yes, God bless Texas.
Amen to that. Amen to that. Do you see on the papers today, George Soros is betting on a collapse of our economy.
Betting on it big time, too. Billions of dollars.
Yeah. He's betting $2.2 billion as of now, and he may up that. What he's done, folks, is he's sold short. When you're selling a stock short, you sell it at today's price, and then you buy it later at a lower price to pay off the debt. And he has actually bet $2.2 billion of American securities that he's selling short. And this guy is worth billions and billions and billions. He owns a couple tons of gold. So he's expecting it to collapse pretty hard. Back in 92, the British government was practically collapsed because he did the same thing to their economy. And
I believe Miramar as well.
What's that?
Miramar.
Oh, I didn't realize that.
The country of Miramar. He did it there as well.
Oh, I didn't realize that. I didn't know that he had done that. Yeah, he's pretty evil. He's if you don't know George Soros, he's not just an investor. He's dumping millions and millions and millions of money into liberal campaigns, liberal activist organizations such as this. So he's trying to destroy America right alongside Obama. In fact, Obama probably takes his marching orders from George Soros. So
yeah,
that was my top complaint of the night. And get ready for more terrorism, because the number one anti-American in the entire country, Barack Hussein Obama, is turning his back on Congress. Shocker. Ignoring all the advice from the top security advisors, top military intelligence, after releasing five high-level Taliban commanders into the field out of Gitmo, and one of them was had his picture taken along with five or six skulls that were beheaded from their previous owners. And now what he's doing, he is allowing Libyan military people to come into America, take military flight training and nuclear school from America. This was all cut off about three decades ago because of all the terrorism that was coming out of Libya. The Libyan military was doing it. Gaddafi himself was involved in the downing of that jetliner over Lockerbie. And we cut off all ties of training and bringing their people in to train them at our expense. Obama says, oh, what's the worst that these Libyans can do? Can you remember Benghazi?
Yes.
It was Libyans that pulled Benghazi off. Now Obama's going to let these people come over and learn how to fly planes. Oh, yeah, what harm can you do with a plane, right?
Well, he's dealing with our enemies. That's what he's doing, Tom.
Oh, he is, absolutely. Our enemies being yours and mine, but not necessarily his. His enemies are Israel, England, France, all of our traditional allies.
The American people.
Oh, yeah, and the American people, right, you and me. It's absolutely nuts. And now he's starting up his database. A couple of years ago, I think we're going back three, maybe 4 years, he had a database, he had a website set up. If you hear something online that you don't think is true, send us the information. We'll check it out and we'll deal with it. getting neighbor to spy on neighbor, just like Hitler did. Hitler didn't do it as a database, an online thing, but he got people to turn in their family members, turn in their neighbors, turn in anybody they heard saying something that was anti-state, anti-Hitler. And Obama is starting that up again. It caught such flack at one point, they pulled it offline, but it seems to be ramping back up again.
Makes me wonder if they saw a snake.
Yeah, I think they saw a snake. So Big Brother is watching. So let's see what else we got.
You may not realize that, Tom. I put a post up the other day of Eric Holder arriving in St. Louis, just a little snake.
Oh, and yeah, that snake. That was great. I love that. That was a great picture. Great big, like a 30-foot cobra.
Yeah.
Holder arriving. Ding, ding. A new bill in Congress is trying to ban U.S. citizens, private citizens, from owning body armor.
Yes.
Think about that. They don't want us to have body armor. Why? Because it's their enemies that would be owning it. It would be the Patriots. It would be those that are armed and ready.
But they only have 3 billion rounds of ammunition.
Right. Well, I figured, at first I was shocked on that. There was like four rounds of ammunition for every American. But then I figured out, well, they're not going to kill every American. They're just going to kill the conservatives. So that's about 8 rounds of ammunition per target. But then these are not going to be the military that's shooting at it. It's going to be his private army, his FEMA camps, his private DHS police force. Well, these are typical government employees. They probably go through 40 rounds without hitting the broadside of a barn.
The COPPAs. Remember them?
What's that?
The COPPAs. The COPPAs. They were in St. Louis. They're a feared group. They're kind of like the people who have the compass and the square on their icon, but they're blacks.
Huh. The name doesn't ring a bell at all.
They're more feared than the Blood or the Crypt.
Ooh, that's hard to imagine.
Yeah,
I thought the only thing bloodier than that was the MS-13 and then this ISIS mess.
No, there's a worse group out there, Tom. Yes,
wow.
There is.
I'll have to look that up, brother. I did not know that. But the whole idea of refusing to allow us to have body armor, why would you not want citizens to be able to protect their life, to defend their life? That's absolutely insane. That's absolutely insane, and any congressman that signs off on this is going to get strung up by his own petard, because I'll build a website just for these sleazebags that want to make us vulnerable. It will never pass, but anybody that tries to pass it will be highlighted as scumbags of the week.
Exactly. It'd be like taking gas masks away from the English during the German raids.
Yeah, exactly. And it's just nuts. Not only don't we want you to have guns, we're going to buy up all the ammo so you can't afford to buy any because there'll be so little of it. And then we're going to make it so that whoever does ammo can shoot you. Absolutely
yeah.
Criminal. This whole administration, they'll be driven into the sea. Obama's always talking about the economic recovery. You ought to send flyers out to Florida. Turns out down in Miami, they had a food bank day, and thousands of people stood in line in 98 degrees for hours and hours to pick up a box of food worth $100, meats, bread, vegetables, spending hours in line in that heat carrying their babies to get a box of food worth $100. Someone said, if I didn't do it, I wouldn't have been able to feed my child this week. Nice recovery, Obama.
Oh, yeah.
I'll tell you what. Whenever that guy is talking, he's either lying to us or he's BSing about how he lied to us yesterday.
Let's see what else we got. Oh, you wanted to talk about local government. Great topic.
A couple of things. Great topic. Like to see you.
We're gonna touch on this briefly because we got another break coming up here in just a minute. But actually, let me do this one first. That way we can take that topic on when we come back up and have proper amount of time for it. We've been talking weekly about the Islamic State and how there are hundreds of American citizens and residents that have gone over to fight. Now, these aren't just, you know, Bob Smith. These are jihadists. They're Muslims that immigrated here or snuck over illegally, and they left America and went to fight in Syria and Afghanistan, Iraq. Now they've recruited over 100 Filipino youth that will be packing up and going over to join in the jihad. 100 young Filipinos going over there to lay down their lives for these militant bastards. We just need to nuke them. It's not going to be that hard to find them. We just need to clean house, turn the whole place into glass, and let them start over again. Anybody that can make it to a cave can stay in the cave till the nuclear dust settles. These people are just absolutely evil.
Absolutely.
Absolutely evil. Folks, stay with us. Bill Perryman is going to be right back. We've got two of his topics coming up. So the best part of the show is still ahead. Thanks for coming in.
K-C-A-A. Tom O'Halloran, holding the line against tyranny from Washington, D.C.
I am America, one voice, united we stand. I am America, one hope to heal our land. There is still work that must be done. I will not rest until we won. I am America.
Welcome back. Folks, if you're just joining us, this is the Tuesday night edition of Patriot Radio, and I am your host, Tom O'Halloran. Online with me tonight is my friend, my brother, my fellow patriot, Bill Perryman. Bill, you still with me?
Still with you, Tom.
All right. All right, brother, I'm going to toss the ball to you. You had two topics you want to cover tonight. What's the first topic?
Well, I'd like to see the people. We really need the people to get into the schools and the school boards. And if nothing else, listen to these meetings. You might not become a member, but at least go listen. I think just listening alone would inspire some of you to join the school board and fight back, because Democrats own our school board. They own our city council meetings. They own the town halls. We've got to go and start taking this back at the grassroots. It's got to be done.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And because the Democrats have owned it, the schools are where they are. I mean, they're teaching our kids this common core crap, which is...
That's exactly right.
There's nothing common about it. It's absolute idiocy.
Idiocy. And then I would like to see the Republicans, the ones we trust, and I feel there are a few, such as, you know, Trey Gowdy, Louie Gohmert,
Senator Cruz,
Mike Lee, there's a few. But have them come together and rewrite a contract with America. Make us promises that after this next election that we agree to that they make happen. Seal our border. Send these people out of here and start funding the right things and stop funding the Islamists.
Absolutely. And here's the thing about the school boards and the city councils. And a lot of people say, well, you know, I want to get involved in politics, but I want to run for the state office. I want to be a state senator or a state assemblyman or something like this. If you're running for state office before you've done this city stuff, you're
fighting an uphill battle because the people that get elected to those have already served. So get involved or back somebody that's fighting from the school board, from the city council, from the county commissioner level, whatever form of government you have at the local level. But either get involved yourself or back a real conservative that will drive forward issues that are good for America, that people that are more interested in America than they are getting reelected.
More. Too many of them are getting reelected. We have to take it over at the grassroots. We need to start there, and that way it'll just flow up from there. It always has, but we've not done it in years. I mean, literally, I've gone to city council meetings. I've gone to school board meetings. It is totally on Democrats, and don't you dare say a word. You best go in there with backup. I mean, get at least, if you can, 10 good friends to go with you, because it may take that to stand them down.
Absolutely. And it's so controlled by these leftists now that if you stand up to complain, I did a story on here about a month ago, Bill, where a father was shocked that his, I think it was a 14-year-old daughter, was getting a textbook that had graphic sexual descriptions of actual sexual activity in it.
Yeah.
And he was shocked, and he went to a school board, and he was voicing his opinion, but they have a 2-minute rule, and because he didn't stop right at 2 minutes, they had him arrested.
I saw that.
I mean, the total disregard that they have. You're going to try to teach my daughter how to be a whore, and you're going to lock me up for talking for 2 minutes? I'm the criminal here? I'm the criminal? I'm trying to talk to you for 2 minutes? I'm livid over what you're teaching my kids, and you're upset that I'm talking for more than 2 minutes?
This is insane.
And when you go and you take your friends and you take your neighbors, don't allow them to do this. If one person is getting arrested, the rest of you have to speak up and start chanting, start raising noise, throwing chairs if it takes it.
Exactly.
Don't let them pull this dictatorial crap and tell you to sit down and shut up. They work for you.
Yeah, we've laid down much too long. So, yes, you've got to get in there because the school board, they are changing our children's lives bad for the bad. I mean, they are not aware of a job coming out of school these days. They have no clue what hard work would be. They're not taught that. They're not taught economics. They're not really even taught mathematics. It is, and the history is a joke. Oh, my Lord.
Well, and what history they are being taught is being rewritten by the uber liberals and by the Islamists.
We talked
about this just last week. The Islamist organizations have deep tentacles into all the publishing companies. And Islam is being written into textbooks as being a great thing, a holy thing, a spreader of peace. They don't talk about the murdering slaughter that's going on in every country that they live in.
Exactly. Oh, and another reason I'd like to see our Congress and Senate please come back early is there's a couple of people in D.C. I think about now that are needing arresting, and that would be Lewis Lerner and that Mr. Forskin?
Yeah. There's a whole lot of people that need to be arrested. I don't think we're going to see it. I don't think we'll see it until we take control of the Senate and we actually are able to impeach Eric Holder and impeach Barack Hussein Obama. Then we get a real Department of Justice head in there and start.
I hope we can wait that long. I'm hoping we can wait that long. This deal, I think this. Luckily, this deal in Ferguson has kind of blown back on them, I think. I don't know. It got quiet there. But what they tried so hard to do was start this across the country. They almost succeeded. You don't know how close they came, or maybe you do, but a lot of people don't realize how close we came to a real big disaster.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they're down there throwing gasoline on the fire. Absolutely. Absolutely. Holden gets off the plane and he says, I'm a law enforcement officer. I understand how the police feel, but I'm also a black man. I understand how you feel. We're going to get justice for Michael Brown. What kind of crap is that? Get justice for him. He got his justice.
He should have been arrested right there.
What's that?
He should have been arrested right there.
Yeah.
Where he stood. I mean, where's the sheriff? The way he's inciting a riot right there. We're going to get justice for Michael Brown. But you don't. But what about the officer? Is there any justice for the officer? Where is this officer? I haven't seen him now since, bless his heart, he was half beaten to death. So they won't let him out.
He's gone into hiding for now, and he may have to do some relocating himself. But, the governor was just as bad. I mean, that governor stood there and 8 days ago, a police officer shot a young boy. Wait a minute, young boy? This guy was 6'4" and weighed 300 pounds. He was a thug. He's pummeling a cop's face. You're darn right he got shot. I'd have put a lot more bullets than Wilson put in him.
Well, I think I might have myself. You know, Lord knows how many it took to take him down. Well, we may never know. It's going to be so messed up. See, that's the other thing in America right now. Nobody really, even at this point, with all the forensics, with all the witnesses, we still really don't know what happened.
That's right. Now, having said that, we have heard from people that I consider reliable sources that the officer suffered an orbital socket fracture, which means he was punched in the face very hard. That's serious damage. Serious damage.
Yes.
Now, whether you're a police officer or not, it is constitutionally, that means any state in the country, you are allowed to defend yourself with lethal force if you have a reasonable imminent fear. That means it has to be now. It can't be somebody said, I'm going to shoot you, when 5 days later you shoot him. You have an imminent reasonable fear of serious bodily harm. Well, he's already suffered that. Or death to yourself or another person. You have the right to shoot the bad guy. Now, this officer, if he had that injury, again, we don't know the facts yet, but if he had that injury, he absolutely, without a doubt, has a constitutionally approved, it's the Supreme Court has said, if all these facts, it's imminent, it's real, it's reasonable to have that imminent fear, and you're in fear of serious physical harm, then anybody would have the right to defend themselves. And if he suffered that harm, if he suffered that casualty to his face, there's no way this police officer is going to be convicted of any crime whatsoever. Whatsoever. So we don't know the facts about that face damage, but if he was assaulted, if he suffered that injury, it's a closed case. Take all your forensics, all your bullet wounds, it doesn't matter. He suffered the damage. The guy was standing up. If he was even possibly going to charge him, you've got a right to protect yourself. Folks, we've got another break coming up. Please stay with us. We've got more after the break. I do appreciate you tuning in.
KCAA. Guardian of our constitutional republic, founder of PatriotRadio.net, ladies and gentlemen, Tom O'Halloran.
Stuff your pockets while Rome is burning. I've got a feeling that the tide is turning. I am America. One voice, united we stand. I am America. One hope to heal our land. I will not give up on this fight. I will not fade into the night.
Tuesday night edition of Patriot Radio with Tom O'Halloran, I being he. And I'd like to invite you to tune in tomorrow. We're going to have a little bit different show. I'm going to go over a paper that I wrote a little over 5 years ago, right after Obama got sworn into office. I wrote a paper on what we need to do to get our country back on track. I'm going to go over it with you. A lot of it has kind of been adopted in bits and pieces by the Tea Party just because it makes that much sense. They didn't take it from me. They're just common sense things like term limits and stuff. But I'm going to run over a plan that is unlike any plan that you've heard so far. I go farther than anybody else in what we need to do to get this boat turned around real, real fast. So please tune into that. Bill, you still with me, brother?
Still with you, brother.
All right. Did you see Obama's speech in front of the American Legion today?
No, sir, I didn't. I don't watch him.
He stood up there and tried to beat his chest and say what a great president he was, and we must take our time. We can't rush in to fight ISIS. And we've got to take our time, and, you know, yeah, take our time. That means he's got to go back and play rock, paper, scissors to make a decision on what to do. Got to get his advice from his Muslim Brotherhood advisors.
Well, to my understanding, Syria is now, after he drew red lines and threatened the leader there, they're now our new best friends. Isn't that right?
Yeah, seems like it. Seems like it. He wanted to throw Assad out, and now he's like going to a golf game with Assad, I think. So Obama's addressing these patriots, these soldiers, the American Legion, and he'd say something and pause for his, you know, he's usually having these speeches in front of his liberal friends, the softies, the Hollywood crowd, and the people he hand selects to be in his audience. But now he's in front of patriots, he's in front of soldiers, he's in front of people who love America. He paused for the applause. it never came. He'd talk a little bit more and he'd pause, waiting for them to kiss his butt with applause, and it never came. It was classic. If it was a comedian, he'd have been saying, "Geez, you're a tough room." Oh man.
I would have watched for that now, but I can't stand him. I just can't stand to watch him. I get so many of his replays during the week, you know, you don't need to see it because you're going to get it anyway.
Exactly. It comes to us almost through osmosis nowadays. Well, he was talking about the medical care, and he was telling us that the inspector general looked through the complaints at the Veterans Administration and was not able to conclude that any of the deaths were caused by the veterans not being able to get care. Yeah, what he wasn't telling us is that they were unable to rule it out as well. When you're waiting for medical care and you're put on hold for 12 and 18 months and you die before the 18 months, that's cause and effect, people, okay?
Yeah.
Just because there were no fingerprints on a knife taken out of your back when you died doesn't mean you weren't stabbed in the back by the government.
Exactly.
So he's talking about all this, saying how clean it was, and, yeah, we got to make some changes to this. And then I don't know whether it was a typo in the teleprompter or whether he just got confused, but he's talking about upgrading the staff at the VA, but he mentions the VHA. He doesn't even know what he's saying anymore. He's just so out of touch with reality. It's like, come on, can we hurry up? Roll the teleprompter faster so that I can get it back out on the back nine, okay?
That's it.
Oh. Did you see that last week? I don't think we talked since that speech after the photojournalist Riley was beheaded. And he came out and gave a speech saying what a sad day it was because this guy got beheaded and they're savages and yada, yada, yada. And while the family stepped forward to start talking on their own press conference at the same time, Obama, 7 minutes later, was on the golf course.
Yep.
We've got a guy being buried. Of course, I mean, why not? It wasn't but about a month earlier
that we had a general being buried and Obama didn't go to the funeral. A general, a man that's given his career to defend America, to train our boys, given his career and he's being buried, and Obama didn't have time to take off of the golf course. He was playing golf while the general was being buried.
I know.
It's disgraceful.
How many from the White House went to that funeral?
I don't know that they sent anybody. If they did, it would have been low-level staffers.
I do believe zero showed up for that funeral, that general's funeral.
It would have been a very low-level staffer, like the assistant to the assistant's assistant.
I hear as many as five have now been confirmed coming from the White House for the Michael Brown funeral.
We get a black thug being buried, we're going to send out a whole task force.
Exactly. Oh, yeah. And then also something else about Ferguson and the other ghetto streets that the Democrats have built around America. When you see these kids out and doing the things that they do, shooting each other, just remember that we spent billions on education. Billions of our money went to education. And this is what the NEA and the teachers union have given us. Look across America out in the streets with these poor kids. This is what they've done to them. They destroyed them. And I just wonder, are the American people upset enough to stop the NEA, stop these unions, and let's get back to educating our kids before they destroy each other?
Absolutely. A lot of it is the educational system. A lot of it's the racism that has been flaring up since Obama got elected. And a lot of it is the economy. I mean, the black youth that are unemployed is up to about 35%, if I remember. 35% of black youth out of work. I'd be a little angry, too.
I'm thinking that the real unemployment, I do believe somebody did it. I think Joe Dan. And I want to say it came up to 21%. That's actually where our unemployment
is. It is. If you go to Shadow Statistics, Shadow Staff, I think it is, shadowstats.com, the real unemployment, when you count all the people that have left the job pool, the real unemployment is 22.5%.
Incredible.
But the black youth is up over 35%.
And our MSM will not report that. They just will not report that.
Of course they won't. They won't report the while Holder and Jesse Jackson and Al Sharpton were all off praising the black thug that got shot by the cop in self-defense. That same weekend, there were 32 shootings in Chicago, 7 deaths, including a 16-year-old girl that wanted to be a doctor. Black-on-black crime. They're not going to report that. They're not going to report that. Holder won't go to Chicago and cover it. They don't care. It isn't about the blacks dying. It isn't about Brown dying. It wasn't about Trevon dying. It was about racial tension. How can we stir up racial tension? Black-on-black crime does not divide the people. It doesn't make the blacks hate the whites. It doesn't make the whites afraid of the blacks. Black-on-black crime does nothing. Black-on-white crime does nothing. They need it to be white-on-black crime because that they can raise money on, that they can raise votes on. It's all about getting the votes. It's all about Sharpton and Jesse Jackson, the media whores, the race-baiting scumbags that they are.
Oh, Lord, yes.
These guys standing by with blacks are being slaughtered, abortions, the abortions in the black community. They're dying, they're killing more than they're letting live.
Yep.
And these two could do something about it, but they won't because they make money off the abortion industry.
Yes.
So it's not about Brown dying. It's not about Trevon dying, folks. It's about stirring up racial tensions. That's all this is about. All those riots, they were being stirred up by the left to keep blacks and whites against each other, the same as they fight and do everything they can to keep the poor angry at the rich. Folks,
Bill, God bless you, brother.
God bless
Thank you,
Tom, for having
on.
Me on.
I will be in touch with you. I'd love to have you back again. So I hope I didn't walk all over you too much tonight. I'm trying to get used to having a guest on here. Please give it some thought. I'd love to talk to you during the week about coming back again, okay?
Appreciate it, Tom. We'll do it.
All right. Thanks, brother. Folks, wake up. It's not too late, but we got to get involved. Engage. Engage now. Good night, America. God bless you and yours. This is Tom O'Halloran. I'm out.